have a collection of nodes of or circles. Nodes are given by circles basically, called states. Okay, and each state represents a condition that could occur during the process of scanning the input, looking for a lexem that matches one of the several patterns. So, can anybody tell me about what we are speaking about? So, we are speaking about finite. Yes, tell me.
DFS.
Yes, we are speaking about the finite state machines. It can be DFA, NFA, etc. Right. So, transition diagrams are having edges are directed from one state to another state. Each edge is labeled by symbol or set of symbols, and if we are in some state S and then next input symbol is A, we look for an S out of the state S labeled with A so that we can follow the path and we can reach to some other state. Okay, if such a S is found, then advance the forward pointer and enter the state of the transition diagram to which that S leads. Okay, so go to the next step basically. Then transition diagrams are deterministic. There is never more than one edge out of a given state with a given symbol among its levels. So this is speaking in the context of your lexical analyzer, because if you give NFA, or if you have multiple path for a given input symbol, then your compiler will not work. Compiler will get into some other state and it may be hanged. Okay, so in lexical analyzer, basically what transition diagram we use, they are deterministic. Some important conversions are certain state are said to be accepting state, or conventions are some states we call as accepting states or final state. Okay, this state indicate that the lexem has been found. We always indicate an accepting state by a double circle in the diagram, and if there is an action to be taken, typically returning a token and an attribute value to the parser, we shall attach that action to the accepting state. Okay, in addition, if it is necessary to retract the forward pointer one position, that is the lexem does not include the symbol that go trust to the accepting state, then we shall additionally place a store near to the accepting state. Okay, one state is designed the star state sorry one state is designated the star state from where you start, or initial state. It is indicated by an edge labeled start, and entering from now here, the transition diagram always begins in the start state before any input symbol have been read. Okay, so here you can see one diagram is given. Here we have the start state, which is marked by this arrow and written start here. Okay, now it reads the character to find out the lexem. Say it read the first character less than, next character is equal to, then it will simply return a lexem, relational operator, and it is a less than equal to. Okay, so it will return a lexem like this, which will be stored into the symbol table as well as it will be sent to the parser. Okay, then you can see here it says less than, then it's it reads greater than, then it is not equal to. It is written like this. And so on, the other operator can be detected by this transition diagram. Okay. Then recognition of reserved word and identifiers. So these two things are together here. Reason is, you know, the pattern of these two things are quite similar. Okay. Now keywords, if then all these things are say reserved for a language, if is keywords, then is a keyword. Okay, so these are reserved, not identifiers. Okay, then the transition diagram for identifier lexemes and recognize the keyword if, then, and else, like this. Start, later, then, you know, numbers of letters or digits repeatedly, it can accept, and if there is something else, it will go to some other, you know, state, which is even having a star mark here. Okay, yeah, because it is going to read this character, but not going to detect it. Okay, like there is others may say there is white space and so on. So these white spaces are going to be consumed, but not going to take any effect, right? So this is the thing. Okay. Well, there's two ways that we can reverse a word that took like that look like identifier. Install the reserved words in the symbol table initially. So as I was telling you in the previous time, that the keywords are usually stored into the symbol table and from the beginning itself, so that from the next time when your lexical analyzer will, you know, find some reserved word, it will not be able to enter in the symbol table as a new identifier. Okay, so a field of the symbol table entry indicates that these strings are never ordinary identifier and tells which token they represent. Okay, so this is fixed for the keywords. Okay, now when we find an identifier, a call to install id places. Install id is another function. Okay, places it in the symbol table. If it is not already there, in return and returns a pointer to the symbol table entry for the lexeme. So install id is nothing but a function which stores a new token in the symbol table and also returns the symbol table entry. That means at which position in the symbol table that new identifier is being stored. Understand? Then note that such a transition diagram consists of states representing the situation after each successive letter of the keyword is seen, followed by test, that is non-letter or digit. Okay, that is any character that cannot be the continuation of an identifier. Understand? That means say somebody have written then some digit is given, okay, or something is given which is supposed to be not the part of this identifier or lexeme, you can say better. Okay, say start, it is it read T-H-E, and then it is finding some literal or some digit. Okay, then also it will lead you to some final state marked with star so that it can consume all the letters or symbols it is finding ahead. So and this is definitely a hypothetical diagram for the keyword then. Okay, so it will finally return you there is a keyword then. Okay. So here is another interesting thing, transition diagram for unsigned number. So you can see here, start, digit, then there can be a repetition of digit. So this loop is there, like you have 4, 5, 7. So four, when it reads 4, it goes from here to here. Then 5 is there, so it iterates this loop for 5, then again for 7, it iterates this loop another time. Okay, then if it get a dot, then for this dot it will follow this line. Instead, if it gets a exponent, it will follow this line. Okay, and if there is something else, it will follow this line. Okay, so in this way, it can detect if the transition leads to this place, it will return int. If it leads here, it will return float. If it leads here, then it will be some exponential number. Okay. Now a transition diagram for white spaces. If you see here, see it start. Any delimiter it finds, all of them consumes. So and then if there is something else also they consumes and goes to some state. So and it says that all of them are white spaces. Okay, so okay, so still now we was speaking on different thing which are we are speaking on different transition diagrams which are basically not real, just to represent different thing how it works. We was discussing on showing these diagrams. Okay, but in real, when you will have some regular expression and we will need to generate this kind of diagrams, then how it will it happen? Okay, so that will be done by finite automata. So we all are familiar with finite automata. Previously, finite automata are essentially some kind of graph like transition diagrams with a few differences. So there is a little a few differences from graph, but it looks like graph only. Okay, then finite automata are basically recognizer. It recognizes the things. Okay, they simply say yes or no about each possible outcome. That means say if you have given some identifier name, it will say that it is valid identifier name or not. Okay, so finite automata comes in two flavors. One is NFA or non-deterministic finite automata, and another is deterministic finite automata or DFA in short. Okay, so NFA have no restrictions on the levels, okay, of their edges. That means a symbol can label several edges out of same state and even epsilon, the empty string in possible level. So what happens in NFA, you have a source state. Okay, from here there can be multiple outgoing line for a same input symbol A. Now what is the issue problem with this? If your machine does not have enough intelligence to choose a path, then it will be confused. It will be hanged, or stuff here, and it will not be able to decide that which path to follow. Okay, that is a problem with NFA. Okay, or even if there can be some path without giving any symbol, giving an empty symbol. Okay, so deterministic finite automata have, for each state and for each symbol of its input alphabet, exactly one is with that symbol leveling the state. That means if in your alphabet set you have two symbols A and B, each state in the DFA will have exactly two outgoing A's. One will be marked with A, another will be marked with B. So your machine will not have any confusion that for an input symbol where to go. If it gets input symbol A, it will go to this state. If it have input symbol B, it will go to some other state. Okay, but if it have anything else as input, it will say there is no destination and it will say it is not accepted. Okay, both NFA and DFA are capable of recognizing the same language, okay, called regular language. So what is regular language? If a language have NFA or DFA, anything, then you can say it is a regular language. If it is regular language, you must be able to generate some NFA or DFA for your language. Understand? Non-deterministic finite automata, a little bit more detail. If it contains a finite set of state given by S, S, okay, a set of input symbols given by epsilon, the input alphabet, you know, the empty string also included into it, and is never a member of this epsilon, is never a member of the alphabet. Okay, so exclusively you have this empty symbol. A transition function that gives for each state and for each symbol in epsilon union the empty string, okay, a set of next state. Okay, so we have a transition function delta. We give delta star for NFA. Okay, then a state S0 from S that is designated as the start state, okay, or the initial state is defined. It have initial state, okay, a set of state F, which is set up basically the final states, and it definitely it is a subset of capital S. So it have, you know, capital S and F, okay. So this S0 you cannot may not read here, right here, okay. So all right, S I had already written, not needed. Yeah. Okay. So this is how we define non-deterministic finite automata, and here this S0 belongs to S, and this F is a subset of S. Okay, it means one thing, there can be only one start or initial state, and there can be a set of final states. That means multiple final states can be there. Understand? Now, any NFA or DFA can represent a transition graph, where the nodes are state and the leveled edges represent the transition function. Okay, so there is an edge leveled A from state S to state T. Okay, if and only if T is one of the next state from the state S and input A. Okay. So this graph is very much like transition diagram, except the same symbol can level edges from one state to several different state. Okay, so the which is allowed in NFA, that is not there, and is may be leveled by epsilon. The empty string, instead of or in addition to symbols from the input alphabet. So this is also another thing allowed in the NFA but not in DFA. Now, for example, if you are being given a regular expression ARB star ABB, then you can see here either A or B can be generated by this part inside the parenthesis. Okay, now if I generate only A, parenthesis removed, but this asterisk remains, so I will get either A star or B star from the parenthesis. Okay, this is the simplification of A or B over A or B in parenthesis over asterisk. So the meaning is we are going to have A star or B star. Okay, so for A star, our DFA will be this zero state. It doesn't matter how many A's you are giving, it will consume all the A's. And for B, it doesn't matter how many B's you are giving, it will consume all the B's. Okay, then A, B, B. That means this A, B, B, there is no compromisation with this because there is no chance of deviation of this because it is written simply the characters. So for A, it will go to the next state. For B, it will go to the next state. And for another B, it will go to the another state. So it will, you'll call this is a NFA. Okay, M for which accepts this particular regular expression or language given by R. Okay, so double circled around the state 3 indicates that this state is the final state or accepting state. And this one double circle is there. Okay, and only way is to get from the star state or state 0 to the accepting state is to follow some path that stays on state 0 for a while, then goes to 1, 2, and 3 by repeating by reading A, B, B from the input. Thus, the only strings getting the accepting state are those that end with ABB. I think you understand this language. This language can be defined by this description that all strings, all, sorry, all strings end with ABB. Correct. Then there is the concept of transition table. Those transitions can be tabulated like this in a tabular form. So what we had a transition diagram. Sorry, we had a transition diagram like this. Zeroth state or the start state. We had self loop for A or B. Then for giving A, you was receive you were reaching to state 1. By giving another B, you was going to 2. By giving another B, you was going to 3, and 3 was the final state. Okay, so that the transition diagram, sorry, the transition table can be generated like this. You know, it is the It is having a form like this state and then input symbol. We have input symbol A and B. Okay, then you put state 0 here. At state 0, if you give A, it can lead you to 0 itself or the to the or the 1th position. Okay, one step. Okay, so this is what. Okay, if you give B to the zeroth state, it will lead to the zeroth state itself all the time. So only zero. Okay, and as you know that for NFA explicitly, this is always an alphabet. Okay, so another column will be there for this. Okay, so this column is there. Okay, now from A there is no path mentioned for the empty symbol epsilon. So phi is given. Phi means empty set. Okay, so here these are basically in the second bracket and curly bracket we write set of states. Okay, so from state one if you give A, from state one if you give A, nothing is defined. So phi is given here. If you give B, you are coming to state B. So sorry, if you give B, you are going coming to state two. So two is given here, and for epsilon again, there is no transition. So for from one by giving epsilon, it is phi. Okay. From state two, if you say you give A, no outgoing path for A, so it is phi. Okay. If you give B on state two, it is taking you to leading you to the state three. So three is here, and for epsilon there is phi. So there is no epsilon transaction. So all epsilon transaction will be mentioned as phi here. Okay, and from the state three there is no outgoing path for any of the input symbol. So for A it is phi, for B or C it is phi. Clear? So this is what is called transition diagram. So transition table. So you can understand the transition table can be alternative of this diagram, because all the information of this diagram or transition diagram is now presented in form of table. Okay, so why it, what are the advantages? You easily find the transaction on a given state and input, and disadvantage is it takes lot of space when the input alphabet is large. Here it is only three input alphabets, A, B, and so A, B, and epsilon. So your transition table is small. Now, if you think about, say you are thinking about password, okay? So for password, the pattern will have input alphabet, all the special character, digits, numbers, small letters, capital letters, and all. Okay, so it is going to be a very big table. Acceptance of input string by automata. Now an NFA accepts input string X if and only if there is some path in the transaction graph from the start state to one of the accepting state. Okay. Now epsilon levels along the path are effectively ignored since the empty string does not contribute to the string constructed along the path. I think it is clear as well. So there is nothing. So this is how so you have a string A, B, B. Then the accepting path you may have like something, 0A, then same state, then A to one, then second state, then third state, and it is getting accepted. And for not accepting thing, say you are iterating over this first state or the zeroth state. Okay, so it is never going to lead you to the accepting state. Okay, so if you accept a string, as long as some path leveled by that string leads from the start state to an accepting state. You understand this? So what is happening here? So you have input A, B, A, B, B. This may lead you to the final state, may not. Why? Because of this and this self loop. This A can go with this self loop, this B can go with this self loop, this A can again go with this loop, this B can this loop, and this bee can go in this loop. So all the symbols will be consumed by the zeroth state itself, like this. Okay, and we will never lead to the final state. This is the problem with NFA. Okay. So here is another thing. If you see, sometimes we need NFA as well to demonstrate some of the problems. Like if you see, you have a language L, A star or B B star. Okay. Now if you get string AAA, it is accepted, right? Because it means what? You have either this or this. Okay, AAA means you have A star. Okay, so it is accepted thing. Epsilon is disappear in a concatenation. So epsilon it need not to show separately in the regular expression itself. Okay, so this can be effective, effective tool to demonstrate this, right? But again, you will have the same problem of from zeroth state, whether you will follow this path or this path, because both the path have marked with epsilon. Okay. Okay. So let's